Hi everyone, this is Dan Tavar of Adamontage, and I want to show you this continuation of our vehicle prototype doing this in microvoxels. What's the point of having the whole world made out of little cubes? And not only the world, but also the vehicles, and we'll get to that. Focus of this video is to address some of the comments that we got on the last video. We love the engagement. You got a lot of comments, a lot of views. Thank you for that. Yeah, let's answer some of those kind of themes, but also show off why it's really cool to have everything made out of these microvoxels, or what we call virtual matter. Here we are. We have the scene in front of us. The wheel tracks themselves have been improved, and they are not just some kind of trick. These voxels are real voxels. I can certainly dig into them in the terrain. I can also do it in a way that respects the materials. So you see, when I only remove sand here, for example, it really is only the sand, and you will reveal the rock surface underneath that is there. You might have noticed in the previous video that when you're driving over the sand only, you see the wheels are actually only causing tire tracks to happen in the sand and actually not in the rock. It's actually revealing the rock underneath as we're picking up or removing that sand from the rock. But yeah, there's so many implications on gameplay here. You know, if you have a rut in the sand just from driving around, let's say, do it enough, you know, you're gonna end up with deeper and deeper. Yeah, we're actually making deeper and deeper tracks in the sand here. It's not just some kind of texture map trick or something like this. With our tools that are quite crude still, we are working on a completely new UI for these editing tools, and it's coming in shortly here. We mark a piece of this sandy hill, and we simply do a cut and paste. I think everyone is familiar with that concept from just computing in general. We had a nice piece of this chunk of this terrain. We have cut it out from the terrain. As you can see, this is very kind of easy to understand, I think. We can now, of course, use this and put it, let's say, over here. All right, just put it, sink it down a little bit there. Nice. We can paste, really, is what it is in kind of normal vernacular. But yeah, stamping it into the world is trivial to do here. We can do it quickly and easily and multiple times, very kind of endlessly, actually. This is one of the beautiful things about voxels. And we can, of course, rotate this however we want, stamp it again, make this into a fun jump, perhaps. The thing that can be done here is quite intuitive and quite fun, actually. Now we've created a jump. Woohoo! I can, of course, paint this. I can do everything I can do with everything in the world, including the vehicles. We'll get to that next time, though. Woohoo! Trackmania comes to mind. Trials. And a couple of the comments from... Oh, nice. I think it kind of speaks for itself, actually, so... We could drive up here. You know, having this scene be completely editable like this, where I can create whatever crazy track I want. That's an object right now, so that's why I drove straight through it. I don't believe the collision detection of objects is working, but of course when I stamp this, it'll be a solid thing that I'm probably stuck on now, actually. So yeah. Okay. Well, that was not what I intended. It's not what I intended, but that's a hint for the next video. Stay tuned for that, but you get the idea. So I want to address the comment that some folks had in the previous video. We should have some particle effects on the wheels, and absolutely we should. This articulated arm should be animated. These are not hard things to do, it just takes time. But what I could do is activate these little scripts that I've attached to these wheels. When I drive around now, we have a nice little particle effect happening on the wheels that are colored after what you're driving over, which is not always a perfect solution. We should not have the dust maybe happen over rocks, for example. But yeah, you get the idea here. This is just a script that the guys whipped up in a few minutes. You could also imagine that it would kick up rocks and so on when the wheels are spinning fast enough. You could be kicking rocks and so on behind the car, or if it's like a mud, for example, you could have it actually stick on whatever it hits based on some kind of stickiness material property. We are still just prototyping and dog fooding. It's something that we will tinker with and also let you guys tinker with. You know, this is actually where we're going with this. The scripts that run everything here, the simulation, the UI, the gameplay, they're all going to be available for everyone to play with. This is next level UGC, user-generated content. This platform is going to let you do everything you possibly could want with the, again, the gameplay, the simulation, the particles, the UI, and so on and so forth. It's all driven by the same Lua environment, scripting environment here, and everything you've seen us do and will see us do is done in that environment. And we will make those scripts available to anyone else to modify. Anyway, that's this video. See you in the next one, where we're going to cover what you can do with these vehicles. This is where it gets really exciting. All right, guys. See you then. Bye.